Welcome to 5 Minute Families. In this series, I aim to give you a quick introduction to some of the common plant families found in the UK. Learning to identify plant families is a great help in identifying individual plant species you come across. If you know the family, then you know where to start looking for the species in a guide, and identifying the family is an achievement in itself. Plants are classified into families based on characteristics that they share. This is then narrowed down further into genera and then into species. So, the way to identify a plant's family is to know these characteristic features. I'm starting today with the Asteraceae, also known as the daisy or sunflower family. This is the largest plant family in the world, with around 23,000 or more species. The family is sometimes still called Compositae, an older name referring to the plant's flowers. Members of the Asteraceae are found pretty much everywhere except Antarctica. They may be either annual or perennial, and are mostly herbaceous or shrubby plants. The Asteraceae include species used for food, like the sunflower, Helianthus annuus, and lettuce, like Tucca sativa, as ornamentals, like Chrysanthemum and Dahlia, for medicine, such as Arnica, Arnica montana, and the chamomile, Chamomillum nobile, and of course, wildflowers like dandelions, Turexicum, thistles, Cerium, and the daisy, Bell's perennis. Many of these last are often regarded as weeds, but give them a break. They are part of our natural flora, they're good for pollinating insects, and a lot of them are attractive. I defy you not to be at least a little bit cheered to see your first yellow dandelion in spring. In the UK, Asteraceae is the second largest family. That accolade goes to the grasses, Poaceae. Most of the UK species are herbaceous. There are several hundred UK species, even more including microspecies, found in things like dandelions and the hawkweeds, Hyraceae. So, the main feature of this family are its inflorescences. The distinctive, often large, daisy-like flower heads. Anything that looks at all like a daisy is almost certainly in the Asteraceae. These flower heads are actually made up of dozens of tiny flowers called florets, all arranged on a base. These compound inflorescences are known as capitula. So it's one capitulum, two or more capitula. Each of these tiny florets has five petals, five stamens fused into a tube, and a stigma and style in the middle. But here's where it gets interesting. Asteraceae flowers come in different forms, known as disc florets and ray florets. Ray florets are much showier than disc florets and serve to attract pollinators, as the majority of Asteraceae species are insect pollinated. In the daisy, the disc florets are the ones packed into the middle, and the ray florets are the petals around the outside. The five petals of both disc and ray florets are fused together, but they are all there. Although the ray florets look like they have only a single petal, if you look closely at the tip of this, you will see five tiny teeth. These are the tips of the fused petals. Some species, like daisies, have both disc and ray florets, and others might only have ray florets, like dandelion, or only disc florets, like groundsel, Senecio vulgaris. The capitulum is surrounded by protective bracts called phyllaries, known collectively as the involucre. The number, position, and appearance of these phyllaries is often important for identifying individual species. The ovary of each floret contains one seed that turns into a dry fruit called an achene. You might be wondering what's happened to the calyx, the ring of sepals around the flowers, in all this. Well, the calyx may be absent or reduced, but is frequently modified to form a collection of hairs or a kind of parachute attached to the fruit, called a pappus. This pappus enables the seeds to be dispersed by the wind. This is what you see in dandelion clocks and thistle fluff. Other species, like burdock, Arctium minus, have hooks on their fruits that allow them to attach themselves to animal fur or people's clothes. The leaves of Asteraceae are very variable, some with smooth margins, some with lobes, but are generally alternate and often take the form of a basal rosette, like in dandelions. So remember, if it has a capitulum, which is a daisy-like flower head, With an involucre, which are the protective bracts, you have yourself an Asteraceae. Keep an eye out for these three species in your garden or on your street. Dandelion, Taraxacum, Daisy, Bellis perennis, and Groundsel, Senecio vulgaris.